Welcome friends to Kasam EXCELL once again. Today we shall be discussing something new, something totally different. That is ABCD. You might have studied ABCD, A for apple, B for bat and C for cat, like that. But this is totally different thing. This ABCD is for corporates, for corporate employees and all those who are working in corporates. It is very easy and convenient, but it gives some lots of sense. So if you remember this ABCD, then we are damn sure that you will never fail in your goals. So let's start off just now. So A for affirmative. Affirmative means always positive. B for buoyant. Buoyant meaning always remaining at the top. C for courageous. Courageous meaning powerful. D for daring. Daring means having courage to do anything. E for eminent. Eminent means distinguished or above others in the rank or position. F for famous. You need to be popular for being in the corporate world. G for geek. Meaning expert person in respective field. Whatever field you are working in, you should be expert in that. Then only you can stay up or you can step up in the corporate level. H for humorous. Meaning a person who takes things lightly. This quality is also needed for each and every person, because sometimes this humorous character is being needed. Otherwise you may be expelled out. I for intelligent. It is self understood that intelligence, you need not explain anything regarding that. And J for joyous. Meaning always being happy. Whatsoever you are doing, you do it happily. K for knowledge. Meaning a person with good knowledge. Knowledge is actually required for each and every field. If you do not have knowledge, then you cannot do anything. Then L for leader. Leader, it is a basic quality which is needed in each and every corporate person. And the meaning of leader is a person who is having tendency to lead. M for master. Now this meaning is having perfection in anything. Means if you want to stand up anywhere, then you should be master of that field. Each and every loopholes or each and every positive thing you should know, then only you can excel in that particular field. N for notorious. There is something different. It means you become childish and you walk out of track doing mischiefs. So something different, not as a routine thing. You should be notorious also. That see, when the atmosphere is too hot and everybody is angry, so at that time if you are a notorious fellow, then you make something, some action or some query or whatsoever something you might do, on that basis the whole atmosphere would be changed and everyone would be happy. So notorious character is also needed. Then O for orator, meaning a person who has tendency to speak in public. This thing is also the basic thing for any corporate person, because whensoever you want to explain anything, so you should not have public fear, and that can only be there if you are not having means if you are having full courage, then only you can do it, otherwise not. So you should be a good orator. Then P for perfectionist. Earlier also it has been there that you should be perfect in each and everything which you do, up to your level. You should be perfect up to your level. It doesn't mean that if you are not perfect according to other person, but you should do optimum at the best of your abilities. That is called perfection. Then Q for qualified, meaning a person having some qualification. So qualified person is needed in the corporate, because qualification also matters. Nobody would accept you without your qualification. And furthermore, when you are a qualified person, you are having a degree. So at least you are studying something regarding that particular subject, and on that basis, if you work hard, then you may excel in that particular field. So qualification is also one of the good qualities. R for rocking, means a person who has tendency to rock, means being popular. See, rocking personality, you might have heard something, some term like that. So who are a person who has a tendency to be free, to work hard and to work with full devotion, will always be rocking, and he or she would be always famous. So rocking character is also required. Then S for seductive. Now this term seductive, it is something different, meaning a person who can influence another person completely so that his work is being done. This is the most important and utmost thing required in any sort of corporate level. Because whensoever you want something to be done from another person, then you should be such an influential personality that that person would agree with your terms and condition, and he would accept, he or she would accept all those terms, and your work would be done. So seductive in the sense you are having such a power that you can influence any person. So that is also an utmost important thing in this corporate field. Then T for thriving, meaning a person who does his 100% to achieve his goal. Thriving personality. Thriving means that you have to do each and every possible thing for the work which has been allotted to you. It doesn't mean that somebody gives you some work which is too tough. So you can't say that I will not be able to do it. It is not the proper answer. You have to thrive for it. Another term would be that do or die, that type of thing. That just I have to do it, nothing else. So that type of thriving should be there. That type of craving should be there. Then only you can excel in corporate world. So T for thriving. Then U for unabashed. Now this is something different. Unabashed, you might have not heard this word maybe. Meaning a person who does not get embarrassed. That is, unabashed is very nice thing in corporate level. It is also very much required quality. See, sometimes happens that your opponents or anybody would try to harass you, would try to torture you. Many things could be possible. So during that period, if you are cool enough and if you are able to ignore each and everything which has been tried by another person to harass you or to torture you or to ignore you or to stop you from proceeding further, then definitely you will be able to succeed. This is very tough, and this quality should be maintained and cultivated by each and every corporate person so that he or she does optimum level at his 100% and he will excel in his or her field. Then comes V for vigorous. Vigor, you might be knowing, vigor means power, and complete meaning as a person having full strength to do work without being tired. So vigorous character is also required. See, if you are being allotted a job and if you say, sir, I am tired or I will not be able to do that and all those stuff, then these things will not be tolerated by your boss or anybody else. They would only expect one thing from you, that you have to do it, that's it, nothing else. They don't want any excuses. So for that, vigor should be there. You should be so vigorous, you should be so powerful that you don't get tired, either physically or mentally. Both of these things should be maintained. So V for vigorous. Then comes W for wise. Wise meaning a person having tendencies to resolve issues effectively without doing harm to anybody. This is also very, very, very important thing. See, it happens that you might do your work, you might complete your task, but at the same time, that is your moral responsibility that you do that task in such a manner that your task is being completed and then the another person or nobody is being affected, nobody gets tortured, nobody is feeling hurt. So, and in that manner, if you are able to do your task, then you are a wise person. So wiseness is very, very important. W for wise. Then comes X for genial. Genial is also something new for most of the people, but we would like to explain regarding that. Genial meaning is who is hospitable or inviting strangers or guests. Now this thing is also very important, that how much you are able to impress some strangers or some new person whosoever approaches to you or whosoever you are trying to approach. So that is the genial thing. If a person is genial, he will be able to entertain the newcomer, the stranger, and he or she would be able to tackle that person in such a manner that that person would become a part of your business or a part of your whatsoever project is there, and in such a manner that he doesn't feel that you are trying to take out work from him. So such a homely atmosphere is being created by that person that another stranger person would feel simply like home feeling, and he would definitely entertain that and definitely would like to work with that particular person. So X for Xenial. Then comes Y. Y for Eugen. Now Eugen is also something totally new one. The meaning is a deep or mysterious person. See, sometimes it happens that you should be somewhat Eugen means you should hide something. You cannot expose everything to everybody. So for that purpose, you should be a Eugen person. You don't expose everything to everybody. Fine. You just be alert that this thing should be not told to this person, and this thing should be told to this person. So you have to decide that decision power should be there, and that decision power is being present in the person who is Eugen. So Y for Eugen. And full and final is zest. Zest means a great enthusiasm or energy. So full and final thing for the and ABCD ends over here with zest, Z for zest. So the person who is having full zest will do each and every task allotted to him or her with full enthusiasm, full courage, full devotion, full emotional attachment, and whatsoever 100% he or she will give to the work, and then definitely he will succeed, he or she would be succeed in his or her task. So friends, hope you enjoyed this ABCD for corporates. We would advise you to share this ABCD to each and every person. This ABCD should be shared with each and every WhatsApp group, Facebook group, so that everybody knows that what should be done to be successful. So this is the main concept we have studied, and we are just sharing with you all so that you also can become successful. Okay, so bye, take care, bye bye.